A Collingwood property where two brutal murders occurred in the 70s is on the market. Aiming to secure $500,000 for the Easy Street property, the agent has failed to disclose the history in its advertising.
At this very house 34 years ago, two young women were brutally murdered. Now the Easy Street property is on the market, and it's described as having played its part in Melbourne folklore in past generations. Some find it insulting.
Showing no respect to anyone that was actually involved in it, no consideration for their pain or suffering, and it's all about selling a house. You know, and I'm sorry, I just think it's disgusting.
To promote it in that way just brings hurt and heartache back to the family. It's an absolute disgrace.
There are laws to prevent real estate agents misleading potential buyers, but they don't have to be entirely open either.
So if they know that a certain thing has happened in a property and they are asked the direct question by a prospective purchaser, they have to answer it very clearly.
Susan Bartlett and housemate Suzanne Armstrong were stabbed a total of 84 times. In another room, Suzanne's 16-month-old son Gregory was untouched. He was discovered crying in his cot 2 days after the killings. The murderer has never been found.
The next open for inspection will be held here on Thursday, and if the agent fails to disclose the history when asked, they could face fines of more than $1 million.
Especially calling it folklore, as in it's like something to be proud of almost.
But get rid of that first line.
Well, he could mention that there was an unfortunate happening.
Under instruction from the owner, the real estate agent refused to comment. Melanie Davies, 10 News.